हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज सीमा सिंह, योर एसएससी टीचर। आई विल स्टार्ट चैप्टर 7 इन हिस्ट्री, क्लास 7। ह्यूमन सेटलमेंट्स इन द इंडियन सब कॉन्टिनेंट हैज स्टार्टेड ग्रोइंग इन रिवर बेसिन एंड अदर फर्टाइल एरियाज। द पीपल इन दीज एरियाज हैड सेटल डाउन ड्यू टू कंटिन्यू एबिलिटी ऑफ फर्टाइल लैंड, वाटर and moderate climate. People continue to live in their traditional way. In this chapter, we shall see the social changes which took place during the medieval period in both type of settlements. The settled communities. Since the Vedic time, the Hindu society had comprised of four classes, also known as castes. These classes were the Brahmins, who were accepted to be learned people and follow or take on matters connected to religion. The second class was the Kshatriyas. This class comprised of those people who took on the profession of protecting and safeguarding the community. The third class was the Vaishyas, or those people who were involved in economic activities. The fourth class was the Shudras, who were doing the job of cleaning such professions. Over a period of time, the numbers of people in the caste also grew by large numbers, and there was a requirement to divide them into further subcastes for identification and other social demonstrations. The nomads. Nomads were the people who moved with their complete belongings from place to place in groups. Their movement used to cover large distance, and this was based on animal and carts. They generally lived on milk and other pastoral products. They used to trade the produce of their animal like wool, milk, ghee, etc. with those of the people who had settled down a peasants. One of the prominent groups of nomads were popularly known as Banjaras. They had a system of moving in carts and in caravans from one area to another. They used to transport grains to the city market. The tribe. The settlement on the groups of people who continue to live on the hinterland of forest. Hills and mountains are commonly known as tribals. They practiced their own social customs, religions, and occupations. They had their own tribal chief who dictated the administrative rule and administrated justice in case of disputes. Tribal chiefs were normally the elderly who were considered to be wise and powerful. Their culture did not have any division in terms of caste or lineage. They worshipped the nature which they feared. They also worship their ancestors and spirits. Occupation. Agriculture was the primary occupation, but open land and patches were not commonly available. They were forced to practice shifting or slash and burn cultivation to maintain the fertility of the soil. Slash and burn method. Trees are cut and bushes are burned on a patch of land in the forest and the crop is grown. When this land loses its fertility, it is left and people move to another place, and same method is followed here. The various tribes in India were the Bhils in western and central India, the Gonds in the central India, and the Marwas, Vathras and Bavages in the South. Administration. They had defined territories, and the tribal chief normally controlled these regions as if they were kingdoms. They took advantage of the difficult ground conditions to ward off threats from outsiders who tried to capture their territories. With the changes of times, they did adopt some administrative rulers of the villages nearby and improved way of agriculture. They also started trading their produce in the settled communities and bartered them for other requirements. Thank you very much. We will meet again a new chapter.